Good evening. There are grave concerns with a monster bushfire bearing down on towns just outside Ballarat, threatening lives, homes and properties.
The out-of-control blaze is already 5,000 hectares and growing, with many residents told to get out immediately. Mimi Becker has the latest.
Out of control, a monstrous bushfire heads straight for Beaufort. An emergency warning issued. Residents told to evacuate immediately. A blood red sun and huge smoke cloud looming over the landscape.
That is our sun right now.
You haven't really got time, and just put the cats in the baskets and just leave us what clothes you've got on.
It's a battle from the sky. 11 firebombers hitting the blaze from above, supporting more than 30 CFA crews on the ground.
Leaving immediately is the safest option for those communities.
Conditions will get worse before they get better.
Properties are under threat. Firefighters doing everything they can to save them. This shed up in flames.
It was getting worse by the minute, so.
To those individuals and families and the farming communities who have evacuated, our thoughts are with all of you right now.
An evacuation centre has been set up in Ballarat.
Seeing the little spot fires appearing all around and thinking, yeah, it's a bit more serious than we thought.
Anxious residents taking shelter, unsure whether they'll have homes to return to.
As I was leaving, the fire was coming back over the musical gully towards the house. So I don't know what's going to be there when we get home.
And Mimi Becker is in Ballarat tonight. Mimi, looking ahead, the next hour is going to be crucial.
Alicia, it's expected that the winds will change direction between now and 7 p.m. and that will mean that the fire will also change direction and more communities will come under threat. Extra resources have been called in from New South Wales, but right now 1,000 firefighters are currently on the ground trying to bring that blaze under control. As for the residents of Beaufort, many of them evacuated here to Ballarat, where they're receiving help from the Red Cross, Salvation Army and government services. But for them, they say it's going to be a long and anxious night ahead, and they feel for the crews that are working out there on the ground, Alicia.
Yes, very concerning. Okay, Mimi, thank you.
The temperature has nudged 40 degrees around Melbourne, with gusty winds whipping up grass fires in the city's west and southeast. Reid Butler joins us now for more. Reid, the main concern has been this thunderstorm activity that's come through late in the day. Take us through what's happening right now.
Well, Tom, the sky certainly looks pretty nasty behind me there, and there's a bit of an orange glow in the air too as a result of those fires burning in the regions. But so far there have been no significant reports of heavy rainfall or lightning strikes. A bit of rain is starting to hit though as we go to air this evening. That is the good news though about the lightning strikes. In bad news, there have been more power pain for at least 5,000 homes and businesses as a result of really blustery winds across the city today. Many of them AusNet customers who'd only just got the power back after losing it during last week's devastating storms. I'm told tonight the worst affected area, among the worst affected areas, is Cranbourne in the southeast. The cool change, thankfully, is imminent, but it would have been a horrible day to not have air conditioning. Here is how Melbourne dealt with the hot weather. If you can't beat the heat, bask in it. Umbrellas, the best defence against Melbourne's scorcher, until they're not. Temperatures climbing to the high 30s across the suburbs and even hotter elsewhere.
Around 39 and 40 degrees at Geelong and Avalon.
40 is a lot, but yeah, I think after being so cold, we can't complain. Let's just embrace it.
Those who managed to get some sleep woke to balmy conditions, and the mercury had hit 30 by late morning.
It's an extreme weather day.
But emergency services have been worried about more than just the heat. And this is the area of key concern. These gusty northerly winds combine these conditions with this dry heat. Well, that is a recipe for disaster when it comes to fire risk. The blustery conditions did whip up grass fires in the suburbs. One scorched 15 hectares in Bacchus Marsh, but was brought under control in about an hour. In the southeast, the Peninsula Link at Langwarrin was blocked for part of the afternoon after a small fire broke out. The dangerous weather also closed dozens of schools across the state, including Warrandyte Primary. Students moved to Templestowe Heights Primary School for the day. All schools will reopen tomorrow.
There's a range of local arrangements to ensure that kids are as safe as possible.
Today was among the hottest we've had this summer, and many made the most of it. These elephant calves kept themselves cool at Melbourne Zoo, and at bars and pubs, cold pints were the best way to beat the heat.
If you look behind us, our taps are nice and icy. The beer is cold, the margaritas are cold.
And the party continues with the cool change we've been waiting for, sweeping the city right now. Reid Butler, Nine News.
Well, the bushfire threat is unfolding as we go to air tonight. Let's head to the State Control Centre for more on it. CFA Chief Officer Jason Heffernan joins us. Jason, where are the areas of most concern right now?
The areas of most concern is that Bayindene fire that is currently being burning through communities such as Beaufort, Raglan, and heading east along towards to the Ballarat region there. The fire situation will get worse before it gets better, because we are expecting that frontal system, that wind change, to move through the fire ground in the next 60 minutes. That will bring a shift in winds from those northerly directions and westerly direction through to a southwesterly, and we're looking at wind speeds at around 40 to 50, may even up to 80 kilometres an hour. The fire size at the moment is quite significant. It's 5,000 hectares. It's been spotting anything up to 2 to 3 kilometres ahead of itself for most of the day. And that side of the fire will now then become the fire front. So my concern for the moment, and there is an advice message for stay informed, for those communities from a line from Amphitheatre through to Lexton, you will be required to take action in the next couple of hours, and you'll be able, you must stay up to date with the Vic Emergency app. I have two sources of information, because when that wind shift hits, those communities and surrounds will be at danger in the next couple of hours.
All right, really important information there, and we know you're busy, so we appreciate your time. Chief Officer Jason Heffernan, thank you.
OK, let's go to Lavinia Nixon now with more on today's extreme weather. Lavinia, the cool change, it has started to move through Melbourne.
What a relief, Alicia. It hit the Geelong area late this afternoon, knocked temperatures down 10 degrees in just a few minutes. That came as a welcome change after a maximum of 40. The city reached 36 today and has only dropped a degree from there, but the change is knocking on the door. Thunderstorms have started to develop, and while they're likely to be isolated, any lightning strikes pose a risk of sparking more fires, especially with the lack of rain expected. I'll have the latest on developments along with the timing of the change for the rest of the state later in the bulletin, Alicia.
OK, Lavinia, we'll see you a bit later on.